Assalamualaikum friends, welcome to my YouTube channel. Today I am going to discuss how to implement particle swarm optimization technique for automatic generation control of two area power system in MATLAB Simulink software. Friends, to implement PSO technique, first we need the conventional model of automatic generation control of two area power system in Simulink. For your convenience, I am considering this simple automatic generation control model of two area power system as shown here. On this topic, I have already made the video tutorial, namely how to design automatic generation control of two area power system in MATLAB Simulink in two parts. Therefore, if you can watch this video and apply the PSO technique in this model to optimize the parameters of PID controller, then this model can be used for your master degree research or one of the PhD research objectives. Now let's check the frequency response of this model. Run the simulation by clicking on this play button. Double click on this scope to see the frequency response of area 1 and area 2 respectively. You can see its response is satisfactory, which is obtained after several attempts. However, if you notice the response, it still contains large undershoot, overshoot, and very long settling time. Therefore, its response can be further improved by applying the PSO algorithm on this model. Friends, in order to compare the response of this model with and without PSO algorithm, first, copy the whole model and paste it here. Now look at the model. It may be observed that in this model, we are using three integrator blocks with gain block as shown here. It means that we can use three PID controllers in these places. Therefore, first replace all these three integrator blocks with three PID controllers. For this purpose, bring the PID controller block from here. Remove this integrator and gain block from here and connect the PID controller block at this position. Repeat the same procedure to remove these integrators and gain blocks from here and connect the PID controller blocks at these positions. Friends, in order to compare the response of this model with and without PSO algorithm, we need multiplexer block. Therefore, go to Simulink library, take the multiplexer block from here and bring it in the model. Connect the first port of the block with the output of this scope. Similarly, connect the second port of the block with the output of this scope. Now copy this scope and paste it here. Connect this scope with the output of the multiplexer block to get the combined response of both systems. Repeat the same procedure to combine and compare the response of area 2 with and without PSO algorithm as shown here. Friends, we know that every optimization technique needs a fitness function to optimize the parameters of PID controller. The fitness function in this model is considered as the error of the system as shown here. Most commonly, integral time multiplied absolute error is considered as the fitness function for the best results. Mathematically, this error is given as below. It may be noticed that for two area power system, this objective function uses the change in frequency of each area as well as change in tie line power. Friends, this objective function is taken from the research paper as shown on the screen. I will attach this paper in the download link for your reference. You may download it from there. It may be further noticed from this equation that this error consists of integral of the error of change in frequency of area 1 and area 2 as well as change in tie line power. Multiply with time. Furthermore, the integral of time is taken from 0 to the final value of the time. Now suppose if we run the simulation for 50 seconds, then it means that time will be from 0 to 50 seconds. Let's design this integral time multiplied absolute error in the Simulink model. To get the absolute error for change in frequency of area 1, take this absolute block from here and bring it in the model. Connect this absolute block with this change in frequency of area 1 error signal to make it absolute error. Similarly, repeat the same procedure to get the absolute error for change in frequency of area 2 as well as absolute change in tie line power as shown here. To add all these absolute errors, we need some block. Therefore, bring the sum block from here and bring it in the model. Connect all three absolute errors with the sum block as shown here. Look at the equation again. Now we have to multiply it with the time. Therefore, take this clock block from here and bring it in the model. Similarly, take this product block and bring it in the model. Now connect both clock block and output of the sum block with this product block in order to get their product. Look at the equation again. Now we need to integrate this error. For this purpose, take this integrator block from here and bring it in the model. Connect this block here. It may be noted that this integrator block will integrate the absolute error from time equal to 0 up to the total simulation time. In our case, the simulation time is set to 50 seconds. Therefore, it will integrate from 0 to 50. To see this error, take this display from here and bring it in the model. Connect this display here to see the error. Friends, we will shift this error to the workspace in order to use it for PSO algorithm. Therefore, take this two workspace block from here and bring it in the model. Connect it here. Double click on it and write its name as ITAE, which stands for Integral Time Multiplied Absolute Error. Friends, as we want to optimize the parameters of PID controller, therefore we have to change the fixed values into variables. For this purpose, double click on this PID controller block. Suppose we want to give variable name as KK. As there are three parameters of PID controller, therefore, write here KK1, KK2, and KK3 as shown here in order to make them variable. Similarly, double click on this second PID controller block. Write here KK4, KK5, KK6 respectively. Similarly, double click on this third PID controller block. Write here KK7. KK8 and KK9 respectively. Friends, at this stage we have done necessary changes in the model. Now let's start to discuss the basic program for fitness function in order to use it for optimization. For this purpose, see the MATLAB screen. It shows the basic fitness function program to run. Friends, this MATLAB fitness function program is very basic and will remain same for all types of power system models. Therefore, you can use this fitness function program as it is for your model too. I will share this model and MATLAB function program in the form of link in the description section of this video. You may download it from there. Now let's understand this MATLAB fitness function program. The first line consists of initialization of MATLAB function having the name cost. It may be noted that the name of this function and the name of the MATLAB program must be same. Otherwise, it will give error. You can see both these MATLAB function as well as program has the same name as tuning. In the MATLAB program, tuning is written with KK in the parentheses. This KK is similar to the KK variable which we have already defined in the model. It is because we are optimizing the value of KK. The second line consists of another built-in function, namely assignIn, which is used to assign any value from the model or workspace to the program. Therefore, this line shows that this function takes the value of KK from the model or from the workspace and assign it to the variable KK as shown here. Third line again shows another built-in function which is used to simulate the model in order to get the values of KK, which are basically the parameters of PID controllers. Friends, it may be noted that correct name of the model must be written here, otherwise it may give error. The last line shows the output, which is integral time multiplied absolute error. It may be noted that here length is written. As we know that the simulation time consists of 50 seconds. Now up to these 50 seconds, there will be many values of error. But we want the last value at which time the simulation is completed. Therefore, this length is written to obtain the last value at the end of the simulation. Friends, at this stage, we have done all the necessary changes in the model as well as in the program. Now, we need to perform the optimization of PID controller parameters using the PSO algorithm. For your convenience, I have already obtained the PSO program as shown here. It may be noted that this PSO MATLAB program will remain same for all types of models. Let's discuss the program. The first line consists of number of variables. As we know that in our model, 3 PID controllers are used. Each PID controller consists of 3 parameters known as P, I, and D. Due to these 3 PID controllers, we will have in total 9 variables. Therefore, write here 9. The second and third line consists of upper and lower bounds limits of variables. In other words, it basically asks the minimum and maximum values of the parameters of PID controller. You may choose any values of your choice. However, some research papers have suggested to use the ranges from 3 to minus 3 or 1 to minus 1. Therefore, I am giving the lower bound to minus 1 and upper bound to 1. It means that the PSO algorithm will search for the best results by changing the parameters of PID controller from minus 1 to 1. Therefore, 1 is written here 9 times as well as minus 1 is written here 9 times in square brackets. Next line asks for objective function name. As we have already written the fitness function MATLAB program having the name tuning, therefore here we just need to call that function. This can be written by writing at the rate and its name tuning as shown here. The second part consists of PSO parameters. Friends, this part and its parameters will remain constant for every model. On these parameters, PSO algorithm gives best performance for any model. Therefore, no need to change these parameters. Friends, the basics of PSO algorithm and its program may be learned by watching this video tutorial with title Particle Swarm Optimization in MATLAB YARPIS video tutorial. This video consists of 3 parts and is very helpful for understanding its basic concept as well as its MATLAB program. Friends, at this stage, we have successfully performed the settings of PSO algorithm to optimize the parameters of PID controllers for this model. To start the optimization process using PSO algorithm, run this program by clicking on this play button. Wait for a few seconds, come to the model. You can see it has started the optimization of PID controllers parameters. Furthermore, it may be noted that this model screen is continuously blinking, which means that PSO algorithm is continuously running the simulation to optimize the parameters of PID controller. It also gives the minimum error at the end of every iteration for our reference. Friends, it may be noted that the optimization techniques takes a lot of time to complete their optimization process. Therefore, you have to show patience and wait for a long time to completely see the final results. Furthermore, depending upon the processor and MATLAB version, it may take even more time to complete the optimization. Friends, you can see on the screen that 100 iterations are completed. The minimum error obtained using the PSO algorithm is shown on the MATLAB screen. Friends, in your case, this error may be different due to the different processor and MATLAB version. Furthermore, every time you start the optimization, it may give different results due to the random initialization of the variables. Furthermore, the optimized parameters of the PID controllers are shown in the form of variable KK as shown here in the workspace section. Double click on this variable KK to see its values. You can see it provides 9 separate values for proportional gain, integral gain, and derivative gain of each PID controller respectively. Now double click on this scope to see the optimized frequency response by PSO algorithm. You can see the PSO algorithm has successfully optimized the PID controller and has provided the best response compared to conventional AGC model without PSO algorithm. The PSO algorithm has best response in terms of extremely minimum undershoot and extremely lesser settling time as compared to the without PSO algorithm. Friends, in this video, I have discussed how PSO algorithm can be used to optimize the PID controller's parameters of automatic generation control of two-area power system in the MATLAB Simulink software. If you have watched my video on conventional AGC model of two-area power system, then you might be aware that I have simulated many cases in AGC model for different power mismatches. I will suggest you to apply all those cases here in this model to get the optimized PSO response for every different case, or read any latest paper on this topic to get some idea about different cases. Whatever you choose, this model can be used to complete your master degree or PhD research objectives. Furthermore, you can even write research paper from this model and you can publish it in any journal. By repeating the same strategy, the PSO algorithm can be implemented for any model related to any field in order to complete master or PhD research objectives. For your convenience, I have uploaded this model and MATLAB fitness function program in the form of link in the description section of this video. You may download it from there. That's all for today's tutorial. If you like it, then don't forget to like my video, subscribe my channel, and share this with all your friends so that they may also get benefit from this video. Thank you very much.